tear my heart open. I sew myself shut. My weakness is that I can't do much. And my scars remind me that the past is real. I tear my heart open. Welcome to the first video for Hammerhead Racing and Performance. What we have here is my first full finished car. It's actually a quarter scale of the race car that I plan to race in the UTV RR and some of the short course classes around here in Georgia. Be powered by a GSX 750R. And it'll be kind of a neat project. First one I've ever built. So, big learning experience. It's been a lot of fun so far. Start out with the suspension, which really cool shocks that we got. Found them on eBay. A guy out of California supplies them. Actually, a Chinese-made shock that mimics what you might find on a racing quad. Something similar to what I have on the front of my quad or the back of my quad. They work really well. The resis are actually a little bit of an air tank, and you can pump them up for a big old butt like mine, or let them down for a kid or a lighter woman, so you know the ride's a little softer. We started out with a set of solid shocks. They were just shocks that I manufactured to make look like real ones, and everybody that rode it complained about how it hurt their butt. So I got to thinking further about the suspension and come up with the geometry, and it actually works pretty good for what it is. You know, you can't go off and jump doubles or clear tabletops with it, but it's a little cushy. Doesn't hurt the backside as much. A 6.5 engine, Predator engine, just a stock engine that we put. I made my own exhaust system for on it. It's just a piece of 120 wall, 1 1/4 inch DOM tubing, and then I just welded on a resonator, so somewhat of a one and a piece of 1 1/2 that I had laying around from the car. Make it sound a little bit more loud, a little bit more racy. The intake right now, we just kind of got it all cut up and on there, just so we can test it out today. Actually, going to go to Robert's Cart Shop this week in McDonough, Georgia, and get a cone filter for on it. And while I'm down there, he said that he would drill out the jet. And we're also going to put a little bit higher performance clutch. That one's about already wasted. It's just a regular go-kart cut clutch. Again, I'm 6 foot at 250 pounds, and I'm the one that's been tooling around on it. So we come up and down this driveway, which doesn't look real steep, but it's fairly steep. So it hauls my butt up it, but it's definitely slipping a little bit. So we're going to go with a little bit higher performance so I can make some adjustments to get the engine to come in different and the power to come in different. So, regular karting brakes that you'll find on a regular race kart. Much of the bolt-on parts are from racing karts from Robert's Cart Shop. Pretty quality parts. Billet hubs for the brake and the sprocket. The sprocket's a billet aluminum sprocket that you can change the gearing up or down. I'm probably going to actually take it down a little bit, or take it up, I'm sorry, make it have a little bit more bottom end and not be so fast. It's actually a little bit scary. As fast as it is what for what it is. The master cylinder is actually from a Harley-Davidson. Got a local customizing shop. Stopped by there to see if they had anything laying around, and he liked the idea of what I was building, and he just gave that to me. It's brand new. Had a guy come in that wanted a chrome one, so brand new bike. He took it off and was just laying around the shop, so he gave it to me. Works pretty good. We got kind of lucky on the brass fittings. Screw right in, and everything worked, hooked right up, and works rather well. Handlebars actually came off my racing quad. They were the stock ones that Kawasaki puts on the KFX 450. I moved to flex bars, and if you're into racing quads, well, I'll tell you, flex bars are worth every penny you pay for them. So we had those bars laying around, and we put them on. my friend of mine, his son, enjoys wrecking his 450R quite often, so the steering stem actually came out of, was a bent steering stem that came off a 450R, and I cut the end pieces off and actually took a piece of DOM tubing and used it, welded the ends back on, and it worked out perfect. Tie rods, basically everything, the chassis, the tie rods, the A-arms, mounting points I bought at Summit Racing, but like the, you know, all the whole design came from an idea based on this one. You'll see that has like an A-arm, and I come up with a design which I call the Y-arm, and you know, for all the more it is, it works rather well. Suspension travels, yeah, just a couple of inches, but there again, it's not meant to clear doubles or you know, hit the whoops at 60 miles an hour, so they just give you a little bit more cush. That's about it for the pit cruiser. We're going to get the adorable Marky Nicole to come out here and take some video of me riding it up and down the street, just so you can see how it runs. First movie from Hammerhead and the Pit Cruiser. Hopefully the next movie will be with it completely finished, painted, and ready just to tear up. Thank you for watching, and we'll talk to you real soon. Channel